1998, it was estimated that 663 million people were using unimproved water sources or surface water that year. So there was a need that the drinking water quality may be addressed, and it was a part of MDGs also, but again it is carried forward in the SDGs. The second need is the sanitation, and the sanitation is also a universal problem. And in the year 2015, one third global population had unimproved sanitation, and almost 1 billion had no sanitation facility at all out of 7 billion people. It was also part of MDGs and carried forward to the SDGs. Freshwater stress that was never addressed before has been made part. Was thought that it should be addressed because the water is becoming scarce all of the globe, and it has to be addressed. And it was felt that the water stress should be made part of the world goals. Again, the official development assistance and the community participation was missing to address the water and sanitation issues. So all these reasons contributed towards the formulation of goal number 6. Certain goals and targets against indicators were framed. The goal is ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. And this goal revolves around water and sanitation. It has 8 targets, and there against 11 indicators have been set. These are the targets and their indicators. I will just go through one by one. The first one is the access to safe and drinking water. The second one is the access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene for all, and local defecation especially and special protection for the women and girls. Third target is the improved water quality by reducing pollution and eliminating dumping, etc. And fourth one is to increase water use efficiency across all sectors. I mean to ensure sustainable withdrawal and supply of fresh water to address water scarcity in the region and all over the world. Fifth one is to implement integrated water resource management at all levels through transboundary cooperation. I mean this is the part of cooperation among all nations. Sixth one is the protection and restore water related ecosystems. I mean the ecosystem is being disturbed by continuous withdrawal of water. So to protect and restore the water related ecosystem is the target of this SDGs goal number 6. So 6A is to expand the international cooperation among the countries about the sanitation, water and sanitation related programs. 6B is to strengthen the participation of local communities. I mean this was never addressed before, that the community should participate at all levels to address water and sanitation issues. Against these targets, I will again present the situation of Pakistan right now, because Pakistan is my country and I have to speak the truth. So this is the situation about goal number 6. I'm sorry, it is a typing mistake. So I written goal number 5. It's actually goal number 6. So the score of the goal number 6 is for Pakistan is 46.3, and it is in the major challenge, and the trend is stagnant for so many reasons. This is the indicator-wise performance of Pakistan currently. This is the population using at least basic drinking water facilities, that is 88.5%. I mean 11.5% people have no water, drinking water facility, basic drinking water facility. The second is the population using at least basic sanitation facilities, the services, that is the 58.25, and it is more common in rural areas and most backward areas. And in urban areas, this percentage is quite low. Fresh water withdrawal is 102.5% against, it's a very alarming situation in Pakistan. I mean, the fresh water withdrawal is the percentage of fresh water withdrawal is very high in Pakistan. reported groundwater depletion, it is measured in cubic meters per year per capita. I mean, it is simply the groundwater depletion the groundwater that is depleted by other countries for growing of crops, and these crops are imported to Pakistan. And this in this indicator, the Pakistan rating is quite good. I mean, Pakistan is not importing that crops that are being grown by using groundwater and by depleting groundwaters. So Pakistan has own crops, and Pakistan is growing own crops and not importing the crops through water depletion, through groundwater depletion. Wastewater treatment in Pakistan is quite low, and it is it is an issue in Pakistan also. Again, we will look at the trends of these indicators. I mean, the basic two indicators are the basic drinking water.